Good evening, everyone. I'm Kalani Veerasinghe, physiotherapy student from Faculty of Medicine, Colombo. Today, I'm here to present you my research abstract on effectiveness of face-to-face physiotherapy training and education for women who are undergoing elective cesarean section randomized control trial. Let me begin with a brief introduction to my research area. As you all are aware, cesarean section is the delivery of a fetus through an abdominal incision. Although it imposes many post-cesarean health complications through physiotherapy interventions such as pelvic floor and post-surgical rehabilitation, an enhanced recovery following cesarean section can be expected. The objective of this trial was to investigate the effectiveness of face-to-face physiotherapy training and education prior to elective cesarean section to improve the post-operative recovery. First, we'll discuss with the methodology. This was a single-blinded RCT registered at SLCTR that used stratified block randomization procedure. We recruited 54 mothers from the Soysa Hospital, 27 for each intervention and control groups. Patient education PowerPoint presentation and patient information leaflet were used as the intervention tools for the intervention group, while medical records, visual analog scale, checklist to assess the pain during functionals, SF-36 questionnaire were used as the data collection tools. Data was analyzed using the independent sample t-test. The intervention of this trial consisted of providing a 10 minutes face-to-face physiotherapy education and training session only for the intervention group, after which both the intervention and the control groups were followed up. Post-operative pain score at 48 hours, doses of additional analgesics required, length of hospital stay, pain during functionals, and quality of postnatal life at 6 weeks of cesarean section were then compared between the two groups. I would like to present you the results next. As you all can see, the mean postoperative pain score at 48 hours and doses of additional analgesics for the drugs of diclofenac, paracetamol, pethidine, and tramadol for the intervention group was significantly lower compared to the control group. Even they have displayed significantly lower lengths of hospital stay and lower pain scores for the functionals of turning in bed, sitting, standing, and walking without support on postoperative day one and day two. Their mean SF-36 scores for all the 8 domains of quality of life were significantly higher compared to the control group. The above two graphs perfectly show the distribution of the pain during the functional activities, while the below two graph show the distribution of postnatal quality of life between the intervention and the control group. Now it's time to draw your attention towards the conclusion. In conclusion, I would like to suggest to you that face-to-face physiotherapy training and education prior to elective cesarean section is valuable for enhanced postoperative recovery by reducing postoperative incisional pain, doses of additional analgesics, pain in functional activities, length of hospital stay, and by improving the postnatal quality of life. In the end, we are proposing local hospitals and health education units to initiate physiotherapy following cesarean section, and for that, video presentations and live practical sessions can be used. Finally, more research should be done with larger sample sizes by involving women undergoing all the categories of cesarean section. Well, that brings me to the end of my presentation. Thank you for being so attentive.